All right, guys, I'm making this video as a reminder that you do not be deceived no matter what happens tomorrow. Seven months ago, I had the opportunity to interview one of the Republican candidates for governor in New Mexico, Greg Zanetti. Greg Zanetti was advocating a blockchain-based voter ID. He was advocating this under the guise of combating voter fraud. Now keep in mind, this is a Republican. Now obviously, voter ID is not a controversial thing in the Republican Party, but we're talking about blockchain-based ID, not just normal ID. So some of the questions I got to ask him were very, very important. And I'll put a link to that video somewhere up here in the corner if you'd like to go watch it. First and foremost, I asked him if this ID would be permanent, if it would be just for voting or if it would be used for other purposes. And you can see in his response that he said it would follow you around and he likened it to your social security number, which is used for a whole bunch of other things. You need your social security number to apply for a job. You need your social security number to get insurance. You need your social security number to open up a bank account, to do all kinds of things. Needless to say, this digital ID would not just be for voting. So anyways, I also asked him if this voter ID already exists or if it's just a thought, an idea in his mind. And he said that the system already exists. Then I asked him if this system is going to be publicly owned or privately owned. And he said it's privately owned. So this digital ID is not only something that would be permanent. It's not just something that would be used for voting. It would be used for many other things, but it's something that would be privately owned. And keep in mind, this guy is a Republican. He was running for the governor of New Mexico as a Republican. So whatever happens tomorrow, whether there's fraud that's discovered, some kind of hacking that's discovered, do not let any of these candidates convince you that we need a digital ID. Because this is exactly what the people in the World Economic Forum want. It's what they're pushing for. It's part of their agenda to enslave mankind. It doesn't matter what reason they use to roll it out. What matters is what they will do with it in the long term. So guys, I'm here just to remind you, no matter what happens tomorrow, do not allow them to convince you that we need to take or accept a digital ID, especially a blockchain-based digital ID, aka Mark of the Beast. Your adversary, Satan, is very cunning. He's very deceptive. Don't allow yourself to be fooled by him while he uses people that you think are your friends. Anyways, if you like this video, don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, and as always, don't forget, help out your neighbors.